Welcome to the Univa webinar about our upcoming Drama 2 API implementation. Do you want to access your cluster by a stable and standardized API? Or do you want to create a live cluster monitoring application without constantly pulling the information with QStart and QHost? Do you want to submit jobs from your third-party or in-house application? Are you searching for a long-term compatible way for doing that, and you also want to use an open standard? Do you need a better way for separating different job workflows you submitted as a single user? Then the solution might be the new Drama 2 standard. Drama stands for Distributed Resource Management Application API, which is now available in version 2. Drama 2 defines a new programming interface for applications accessing Univa credentials for job submission, job monitoring, and cluster monitoring. In this picture, you can see different software layers used when integrating applications with Univa credentialing using Drama. On the top, there is an application layer where third-party applications like NIME, Mathematica, or your in-house applications are. Those applications are using the Drama abstraction layer for accessing Univa credentialing or other job schedulers. The Drama layer consists of the Drama C API, which is usually shipped with a job scheduler, and APIs for other programming languages. Typically, those APIs are based on the C API by technologies like JNI in case of Java or CGo for the Go API. Since those non-C APIs are accessing the standardized interface of the C API, they are interchangeable. That means you can use the Go Drama API also for a different job scheduler than Univa credentialing, which supports Drama. Most times, only small changes are needed for porting it. Then, on the lowest level, you have the Distributed Resource Management System, or DRMS, which often offers standardized services through the Drama layer. Important to know is that all mandatory functionality defined in the Drama layer is available in all major DRMS. This was always a key point during the specification process. Which specific functionality is supported within this Drama layer, we will see in this presentation. So why do we have this webinar today? It is because we are about releasing the next major version of Univa credentialing, UG 8.2, later in this year. Univa credentialing 8.2 comes with two large enhancements: highly improved QMaster scalability and the first Windows native port. The improved QMaster scalability is the result of the introduction of what we call read-only thread. A read-only thread is working on its own replicated data and therefore can now be accessed by commands like qsub and qstart in parallel. Before, the master process could only process one order at a time. Now, even when threshing the qmaster and qstart with qstart requests, it is still very responsive to your qsub and qconf requests. With native Windows port, we are enhancing our supported platforms for credentialing binaries to the professional versions of Windows. Even if we have supported Windows in the past, it always required an additional layer between Windows and credentialing. Usually, SFU services for Unix is used for that. This required additional installations and configuration efforts, and did not always lead to optimal results. Now, with porting credentialing natively to Windows, the job submission and execution components can be run directly on Windows, which simplifies installation and usage much. Finally, we will add a test version or an alpha version of Drama 2 in 8.2 or a later release. This webinar consists of 5 parts. We begin with an introduction of Drama and the OpenGrid Forum. Then we will see what the first version of Drama is about and go quickly over job submission examples in C. Afterwards, we will cover the new features in Drama 2 and how it was designed. Then we will spend time discussing the Drama 2 components. And finally, we will conclude with examples how to exploit the Drama 2 C library. Just a remark here. Due to the large amount of functions we have, we cannot go over all of the provided functionality, but the main parts are shown. Drama is an open standard for interfacing distributed resource management systems like UniBug-Rulenschen. Open means that the standard itself can be used by anybody. The specifications are freely available and can be freely redistributed if they or it remain unchanged. Such an open standard has many advantages. So some of them are decreasing costs of software development because in the specification the functionality is clearly described. It protects investments, interfaces are stable over a long term and do not just disappear. It defines a common interface for multiple products. You're not fixed to just one. It helps you support systems which will build in the future when they follow the standard. Support and knowledge and also cooking recipes are also widely spread. Behind this open standard is the Open Grid Forum, or OGF, which have a dedicated working group for the Drama standard. Members of the working group are from different organizations like the Hasso-Plattner Institute, Cloudera, or Univa. OGF describes itself as an open community committed to driving the rapid evolution and adoption of applied distributed computing. The Drama 2 working group was actively working since 2009, where we also had a face-to-face meeting at the International Supercomputing Conference in Hamburg. Before, the Drama working group released several documents regarding the Drama version 1 standard. The root document, the IDL specification, which came later, and then some language bindings. The result of the Drama 2 working group were published were two standards, the GFT 194 and the GFT 198, both released in 2012, describing the IDL and the C implementation of Drama 2. In 2013, thanks to the Hasso-Plattner Institute members Peter Tröger and Stefan Klau, an example C implementation of Drama 2 was published on GitHub. For this year, for the release of 8.2 or a later patch, we are expecting Drama 2 C API in an alpha version in UniBug-Rulenschen. The first version of Drama is a widely accepted and adopted way for programmatically submitting jobs, not just to UniBug-Rulenschen. It is also supported by most other distributed resource management systems. Univa provides with UniBug-Rulenschen a supported C and Java API, but we also support the open source Python Drama binding, which is based on the C API interface. As we saw already on the first slides, many different language bindings are available as open source solutions. The advantage of Drama 1 and at the same time its disadvantage is that it is simple. So it is relatively easy to implement the API for a DRM and therefore it is more likely that it is adopted, what finally happened with Drama 1. But at the same time it lacks of functionality. It really only provides the smallest possible subset of functionality for job submission. On the other side, it is also a very good integrated in Rulenschen. It is not just a layer on top of QSUB, it is implemented on the same internal functions than QSUB. since Drama 2 is not downward compatible, we will not remove Drama 1 from CrewDungeon. Drama defines init and exit functions which need to be called before a Drama function are used or is used, and as a last Drama function. Then you have a job template function which allows you to create job template instances and fill them out appropriately before the job templates gets used in the job submission functions. There are also functions available for job monitoring and control, like suspending or killing a job. You can fetch the exit status and finished jobs or get the current remote status. Finally, a function for waiting until a job finished is available. Additional functions are related to error text conversions and versioning information about the system. Why do we need a new standard for this? One thing is that untouched things are getting old. Even software gets old because the surrounding environment changes and therefore also the requirements. One example here is that nowadays even the smallest compute nodes offer several cores. This must be handled somehow. Compute node topology needs to be reported and jobs need to be request multiple slots. This must be supported directly by the standard. The next issue with Drama 1 is that it is only about job submission and simplicity, as already mentioned. You not only want to track jobs which are submitted with Drama applications, there is also a need for tracking other jobs and even the need for monitoring the status of your cluster resources, like the compute nodes. When doing massive job submits, you also want to group your separate workflows in order to keep them separated. As a user on the vendor side, you want to offer not only a subset of functionality, it requires extensible data structures, which can be accessed in a compatible way. In Drama 1, there is no notion of machines, queues, job classes, and not even slots. Finally, there is a need for clean, object-oriented interfaces, which can be more naturally embedded in object-oriented languages than just providing a bunch of functions. Drama 2 was designed to have such features and still is the least common denominator of submission and monitoring capabilities of major distributed resource management systems, but extensible. We started around 2009 with actively working on the Drama 2 standard, with a kickoff meeting at ISC in Hamburg and bi-weekly conference calls. We also have an active, well, at the moment it is a little bit quiet, and archived Drama mailing list. If you are interested, please follow the instructions on ogf.org to get access. The main work over the years was the creation and especially agreeing the syntax and the semantics of the Drama 2 functions modeled in the interface definition language. After this was finished, we started working on the C language binding, which simply translates that document to the UNCC word. This document is only about concrete C syntax of the required functions. During the whole specification period, we had lots of discussions if some functionality on all systems and if the semantic matches. We considered systems like Condor, LSF, Slurm, Torg, and CrewDungeon. There are still some glitches which needs to be resolved in an updated version. In order to track them, OGS has established a bug tracking system available under redmine.ogf.org. Currently, we work on the Drama 2. The work on Drama 2 is postponed until the first real implementation is available. Drummer 2 consists of 5 components. As a central component, the session manager deals with managing instances of the monitoring, job, and reservation session. Then we have the job session part, which implements all functionality for submitting, controlling jobs and job workflows. Functions for a more global job and cluster monitoring are part of the monitoring session. The reservation session is needed for creating and terminating advanced reservations, which can be used by jobs submitted in a job session. Finally, we have a set of global methods which deals with generic object types like jobs, job arrays, introspections, or optional attributes. The session manager object offers functions for getting sessions. Sessions like job sessions can already exist on the QMaster side or needs to be created there. Hence, different functions are needed. So a create call creates and opens a new job session, which is not allowed when the job session already exists on the QMaster side. For an existing session, you need to use the open call. Similar things happen when a session is closed versus when it is destroyed. When a session is not destroyed during shutdown of the application, the session remains persistent. After opening a monitoring session, you can get filtered list of jobs, queues, machines, and advanced reservations. It is not possible to create a monitoring session since it always opens a global view, depending on the rights of the user which started the application. So you always have to open and to close a monitoring session only. What happens in the background is after opening, the API gets all available information at once from the GridEngine master process. Afterwards, whenever a state change happens, only the updated information is passed from the QMaster to the Drama 2 application. This asynchronity has a big advantage. It decouples your get all jobs and get all queues calls from the QMaster. This means that a programming model which constantly gets the job list is not just possible, it is really wanted. The communication overhead depends on the visible objects. The GridEngine admin user can see all jobs, but a user only its own jobs, independent of the resource or the source. That means independent if it was submitted during a drama with a drama 1 session or with a drama 2 session or just with QSUB. The main functions of the monitoring sessions are get all jobs and get all queues, get all machines and get all reservations, which return object lists. Those functions typically offer a parameter for filtering, which can be simply a string for queues and machines or more complex objects for jobs, which we will see later. A job session will probably the mostly used session type in Drama 2. It contains functions for creating job templates like Drama 1, which need to be filled out, and it is used then as a parameter or as parameters for the job and every job submission functions. It also offers ways for tracking jobs belonging to a job session and ways for blocking wait for specific job states. Further, it provides a way for listing job classes. You now also have the possibility to create or open multiple job sessions at the same time. Internally, whenever you have a job session open, the Drama 2 implementation gets in the background all updates of changed states. Like with the monitoring session, constantly requesting a job state does not result in any communication overhead to the GridEngine master process. Another thing to note is that job sessions are persistently stored as GridEngine objects in the GridEngine master database, which allows you to reconnect to a job session at any point in time. For handling job sessions per command line, the qconf command was enhanced to list and delete job sessions. The reservation session is for creating and terminating advanced reservations. Those advanced reservations have IDs, which can be used later to fill out the reservation ID field in the job template. The GridEngine counterpart would be the qrsub command line tool. A use case for having that available programmatically is multi-clustering. When you create multiple advanced reservations for the same time span in multiple clusters and submit one job in smaller parts to each cluster. This session type is optional in Drama 2 and will not be supported with Univac GridEngine in the first version. Further objects which are in the global Drama 2 namespace are constants, job and job array objects, the Drama 2 reflective interface, data types like lists and the dictionary, information objects like the job info object, template objects, error handling functions, and callbacks. Job objects can be retrieved by the monitoring session or from the job session by the getJobs and getAllJobs calls. Job objects have some data like the job ID, job session name, or state. For more detailed data, a job info object must be get out of the job object. The job info object is created dynamically when the function is called and not when the job object is created. The job object also offers ways for controlling the job, and there are functions to wait until the job is in a specific state. One main advantage is that, like the other objects, it is extensible. The job info object contains the state and when the job is finished. Also, the exit status and the termination signal of the job are available. A list of machines where the job run can be requested, the amount of consumed slots, as well as the queue name. It is also extensible. Since ANCC does not offer built-in data types like lists and dictionaries, Drama 2 specified them. On this slide, you can see the data type related functions in this API. Drama 2 lists have specific types, hence Drama 2 list create requires a constant as parameter which specifies the type of the list. When calling the get function, you need to cast the pointer in the appropriate format. Dictionaries are mapping a string to a string. In order to inspect an unknown dictionary, you first need to get the list of keys by the dict list functions. To check if the value exists for a given key, you can use the dictTest function. In this slide, you can see the monitoring session related functions. As I mentioned already, there is no create and destroy call. In Univac GridEngine, it does also only make sense to have just one monitoring session open at a time, since it already opens a global view. Special is that the job info filter in the Drama M session get all jobs call, which is discussed later in the slides later on. In this example, you can see how to get a specific job by using a filter as parameter for Drama 2 M session get all jobs. The filter needs to be allocated first by using the Drama 2 job info create function. Then the job info attribute for filtering needs to be set. In our example here, we set the job ID simply to 13. After executing the getAllJobs functions, the newly allocated return job list contains either one or zero jobs depending if the job number 13 was found or not. The return job list is always allocated even there is no job in the list. In case the list is null, an error occurred, which is handled here by just printing out the error reason as string. In order to get access, the job is the usual list access functions needs to be called. Different attributes in the job info objects have different filtering behavior. The easiest filter is an exact match, which is supported in the job ID, like we saw, job state, job substate, job owner, slots, and so on. The allocated machine string list attribute is special. It denotes a piercing set for parallel jobs running on a specified machine. That means a job is matched only when a part of the job runs on a given execution node. Since a UGE job can run in multiple queues, the queue master task is taken into consideration for filtering. Wall clock and CPU times are matching jobs which consumed at least that amount you specify in the filter. The remaining parameters are describing a time at the job or after job went to a specific state. It is also an extensible object. On this slide, you can see the different job session functions the API offers. All of them requiring an open job session, which is expected as an input parameter. Special are the get job categories, which returns the new UGE job classes. And note that the wait any terminated and wait any started, which can wait for the set of jobs but return when the first of them entered a specific state. Also, the job template was enhanced so that it offers now a superset of options which were available in Drama 1. Here are all the parameters the job template supports listed. So first, the job needs to have a remote command and arguments. The arguments are usually encoded as a list. You also have a range of submission options, like if it is a rerunnable job, you can submit a job as in a hold state directly. You can present a working directory, which is have to be used by the job. A job category is matched or mapped in that case into a credential job class. A job environment can be set, a job name, queue name, and so on. For host selection, you have parameters like candidate machines, minimum physical memory, which needs to be on the host, the specific machines, OS, and the specific machine architecture. Also, emailing options are available, like in the Drama 1 standard. Further, you have these file redirection. You also know from the Drama 1 standard. New is the reservation session, if you want to use this advanced reservation concept. For parallel jobs, you can now specify min slots and max slots, which was not possible in Drama 1. For limits, we have a dictionary which specifies these resource limits, like a runtime limit, and so on. Unsupported job templates in our grid engine implementation are deadline time, stage in files, stage out files. Deadline time because the specification of the Drama 2 standard is the semantic of deadline is differently specified than what deadline in grid engine means. And of course, the job template attributes are extensible. In order to figure out if a function was executed correctly or an error happened, the return value of the function needs to be checked. There are two different ways the function tells you about success or failure. Some functions return a constant with the drama 2 type, with the type drama 2 error. Like in drama 1, there are error codes for different kinds of situations as constants available. If a function returns an object like a list, an error is indicated by checking if the object is null or not. In order to get the error code for the last case, the drama 2 last error function can be called, which returns the last error happened. Since multi-threaded applications are supported, the last error refers to the last error in the current thread. If a textual description of the error is needed, then the function drama 2 last error text can be called. It returns a newly allocated drama 2 string, which needs to be freed after using it. Capabilities are optional functions which are specified by the drama 2 specification, but are not required to be implemented. The reason for having this type of functions is that they are either not available on all systems or that different systems have a different semantic regarding the functionality, like the deadline submission time in the job submission template. For checking at application runtime if such a capability is present, the drama 2 supports function can be used. It requires the constant describing the capability as parameter and returns a Boolean value about its support by the API. An example how to use is shown here. The check capability just prints out if a certain capability is supported or not. Examples of optional functionality are the advanced reservation sessions, drama 2 callbacks, array job throttling, and so on. The difference between optional and implementation-specific attributes is that implementation-specific attributes are not specified by the specification. Implementation-specific attributes are enhancing drama 2 objects with arbitrary values, which can be then be used as job submission parameters, job or host monitoring values, for example. In this example, you can see how to query the existence of specific attributes during runtime. A setup function is defined which all return a list of attribute names for a specific object. Those implementation-specific attribute names can then be used in order to set and get values out of the drama 2 object. There are three methods defined by drama 2 for working with those attribute names. Drama 2 get instance value retrieves a value from a drama 2 object. Drama 2 set instance value sets a value into a drama 2 object. Both functions require the object as well as the attribute name as input. Implementation-specific attribute values are always using the type drama 2 string, which then needs to be possibly casted into a different type. In order to get more information about what a certain attribute name specifies, the third method, drama 2 describe attribute, can be used. It should return a drama 2 string, which is a human readable description. Now let's compare drama 1 to the drama 2 standard. Both APIs can be used for very fast job submission when the cluster needs to be loaded quickly by large amount of jobs. The job monitoring implementation in drama 1 is limited to jobs which are submitted in the same job session. Also, the queue master is constantly polled when functions are executed. Drama 2 offers a way to track jobs from multiple job sessions and even jobs not submitted by the Drama 2 API, which makes it an ideal candidate to build job monitoring application on it. Also, the communication between QMaster and the API is event-based. That means even when looping around status queries, it does not lead to additional messages or message exchanges between the Drama application and the QMaster process. The QMaster updates the Drama 2 application as soon as the job status changes occur. The Drama 1 API itself is lightweight and limited to a minimum of functionality with a focus only on job submission. The Drama 2 API contains more than a double amount of functions, covering many more use cases. Drama 1 only handles one job session per application, while Drama 2 has the ability to manage multiple concurrent job and monitoring sessions. Additionally, job sessions remain persistent objects in the credential master process. Drama 2 also has a notion of important functionality like queues, slots, machines, job classes, and so on, which are missing in the predecessor. Drama 2 objects are future safe because they are extensible objects, which over time can support many more univacredential specific functionalities. Also, advanced reservations are an optional part of the standard. Cluster monitoring is one of the new use cases supported by the new monitoring session. You can monitor machines, queues, and non-Drama jobs. Since Drama 1 is older and much simpler to implement, it is widely adopted, while Drama 2 is relatively new. So let's summarize the key messages from this webinar. Drama 2 is an open standard for job submission control and monitoring. It protects development efforts. It encapsulates workflows in different job sessions. It also adds DRM independent monitoring facilities. It has a notion of queues, machines, and advanced reservation. It offers extensible objects, which allow to add more univac credential specific metrics over time. The alpha version will be available in univac credential 8.2 or in later patch. It targets really only early adopters, designers of interfaces between third-party applications and univac credential and other Drama 2 implementers to keep a maximum on compatibility also in unspecified edge cases. Thank you very much for your attention. We already reached at this the end of the webinar about Drama 2 integration in univac credential. If you have general questions about univac credential, please write us on info@univac.com. If you have technical questions about Drama 2 or you are interested in testing a pre-release, then you can also write me directly at dgruber@univac.com. I would like to thank OGF for providing a forum for working on open standards. Also, a special thanks goes to the Asso Plattner Institute, which supports Drama 2 by providing an open source example implementation on GitHub.